Vicky. Hiya, Vicky.
Hiya.
How's it going? Going to introduce myself. My name's Vicky and I'm from Westside Wicklow. Give it up for the Westside. Yeah. Alright, anybody here from Westside Wicklow?
East Side,
Westside. I'm better. I'm Westside Wicklow, which it's pure culchy, pure culchy area. Basically, lovely little village that I grew up in. All the neighbours looked out for each other. Well, not so much looked out for each other as looked in each other's windows. thanks. And what the neighbours, if they didn't know something about you, they'd just make it up. They'd just make up shit about you. It's lovely. My education, well, actually, growing up as a child on my estate, or when I say estate, I mean field, our game that we would play would be just running across bales of silage, just running back and forth, and we'd fall down the middle of them. It's hilarious. It was great. Then the education that I got a great education back down home in Wicklow. I was educated in what we like to call a technical school. For the tech. Can anybody here go to the tech? Did you go into the tech?
Yep.
The educators?
Yeah, you know how to saw wood.
There you go! That's exactly what was bringing me on to my next thing. To me, wasn't this true? You didn't need to know English, you didn't need to know Irish, you didn't need to know maths, you didn't need to know French, geography, history, any of those things. As long as the men could build coffee tables, and the girls could make coconut buns to put on the coffee tables. You had a leave insert. You were sorted. Straight A's. Perfect. But yeah, you'd be probably looking at me going, this girl went nowhere. Like, she knows nothing. She's no bit of culture in her at all. I tell you, you're wrong. Little bit. Right. I've been to Canada. Yeah. I immigrated, like everybody else, young people in this country. And I know what you're thinking. She immigrated to Canada. What? That doesn't make sense. People immigrate to Australia. But like I said earlier, I was educated in the tech. So I couldn't spell Australia for the visa application. So I went with Canada. Because there's a can in it. I was going to live in Canada. I didn't know where Canada was. I knew there was America and then there was this above America. And I was like, that's Canada, is it? Santa Claus land. And landed my finger landed on this part of Canada and it was called Yukon. The Yukon. I don't know if any of you know, but it's so far north that it's further than Santa Claus. It's insane up there. Basically, it's like minus 80 degrees in the winter. So you're waking up in the morning, you're checking that you still have all 10 fingers and toes, like, that's just insane. It's also so far north that it takes 6 months for the sunshine to get there, and then another 6 months for it to fuck off. So you're left with 6 months of sun, 6 months of darkness and moonlight. And that just wouldn't work for an Irish person because we wouldn't be able to talk about the weather. Just be every day, it's lovely sunshine today, again, it's awful dark all the time. So I didn't go with Yukon and I moved down to Vancouver. And people in Vancouver, and I know most of you are like, Vancouver? Oh wait, you don't have a Canadian accent. He does, he's an American accent. But, sorry! Sorry. You're like, where's Vancouver? What's Vancouver? Well, Vancouver's very like Cork. As in, I moved 7,000 kilometers away with people from Cork. But it was very similar to Cork in some sense that everybody's really suspicious there. For anybody here from Cork? Anybody? One person from Cork looked him down the back looking very suspicious. He's just there, eyeing out the crowd. But yeah, when I lived away from home, I had to try and keep contact with my friends and family. And now it's very easy to keep in contact with friends and family because you have Facebook. It's a marvellous, technical website. But my mom added herself on Facebook, and she didn't seem to realise that Facebook was for the World Wide Web to see. And we got anybody here that their mothers are on Facebook?
Yep.
Anybody? Yeah. What's your feelings on that?
I stay as far away from
that. Yeah. But I know, and it's hard to, but I was on the other side of the world, and with time difference too, it was hard to catch when my mom was going to be on Facebook, such as like delete what she was going to write. But my mom had no concept of Facebook, or no concept of the fact that everybody could see what she was writing on Facebook. She thought it was like a text message to me. So she'd be, oh, was it saying stuff? She'd be writing, no, I would write something on somebody's wall, and then it could be a fella, and she'd see that, and she'd be like, oh, Vicky, he's lovely looking. What's the story with him? I'd be like, ma, Jesus, blow me, come over here. Then other times then she was getting into the Facebook abbreviations, and she'd write, take care, Vicky, LOL. I'm like, ma, what's so funny about that? She's like, take care, Vicky, lots of love. I'm like, no, that's not what it means. Another time, I wrote as my status, I was like, yay, I got a job. And my mother was the first person to write on it, first person to like it, and the first person to write a comment. And she goes, WTF, who hired you? And I was like, ma, what do you mean, what the fuck, who hired you? And she's like, no, WTF. Well, that's fantastic! I was like, no, man, that's not what it means at all, but God bless her. But yeah, I've now, since I've obviously moved back from Canada, here I am, because I'm doing so well at stand-up, you know, so brought me back. But no, I've moved back from Canada now, and it's great to be back home in Dublin. Back home in Ireland and living in Dublin. It kind of takes you to move away, to move back. The one thing that I'm happy about moving back is the fact that I can say crack without being arrested or people looking at me suspiciously like Cork people. And I can just be like, yeah, I'm going and doing a comedy gig for the crack, like, and nothing is asked about it. Because in Canada, they were like, oh my God, she's on crack. She's looking for crack. Every time I talk to her, she's like, where's the crack? When did you get the crack? Who's having the crack? So it's great now that I'm back and I can say crack. I'm living now on the north side of Dublin. Woo, for the Nordies. Anybody here north side Dublin? The north side? Yeah, watch her. Watch her on your bike. But no, the one great thing about living on the north side is the fact that when I wake up in the morning, I can just leave the house the way I am in my pajamas. I'm like, ready for today. The little things will bring you back. yeah, so that's really it. My name's been Vicky. I've had a great time. WTF, LOL, Vicky!
Calculate.